Dear students, the topic is dispersive power of a grating. What is dispersive power? It is defined as the ratio of d theta to d lambda. D theta is nothing but the difference in the directions of the two neighboring lines, neighboring spectral lines. Suppose there are two spectral lines having very small difference in their wavelength, say d lambda. Suppose the wavelengths are lambda and lambda plus d lambda, so that the difference is d lambda, let it be very small. And if those two spectral lines of wavelengths, lambda and lambda plus d lambda, suppose they diffract in the directions theta and theta plus d theta to produce their principal maximum, nth order principal maximum, say, then the difference in their angles of diffraction is d theta. It's also the difference in the directions. Difference in the wavelength is d lambda. Then the ratio of difference in the angle of diffraction to difference in the wavelength is called as the dispersive power. Now, to get the expression for this dispersive power in a grating, let us consider the nth order principal maximum of the wavelength, say lambda. Suppose we have two spectral lines of wavelengths, lambda and lambda plus d lambda, corresponding directions or angles of diffractions are theta and theta plus d theta. Then the direction of nth order principal maximum of lambda satisfies the condition a plus b sin theta equal to n lambda. Now, differentiate this expression with respect to theta and lambda. See here, both theta lambda are variables. Differentiate, you get a plus b into differentiation of sin theta is cos theta d theta equal to n into d lambda. Or from this, you get d theta by d lambda as n by a plus b cos theta. That is, 1 by a plus b, nothing but n, the grating element or grating constant. N is 1 by a plus b. What is n? Number of lines per meter on the grating surface. So that d theta by d lambda is n by cos theta. This is the expression for dispersive power of a grating. Here d theta, the difference in the angles of diffraction, also called as angular dispersion. So when if d theta is very small, then cos theta can be approximated to 1. When theta is very small, cos theta approximated to 1. So that you get d theta by d lambda as n. Both n and n are constants. Small n, the order of the spectrum or order of the principal maximum. N is number of lines per meter, both are constants. So that this from this, you can write d theta proportional to d lambda. It's a constant. So d theta proportional to d lambda. What the expression says, the angular dispersion, d theta is called angular dispersion. Angular dispersion is directly proportional to difference in the wavelengths of those two spectral lines. And the spectral lines, the spectrum having such spectral lines is called a normal spectrum. Suppose that spectrum here we have two spectral lines, lambda and lambda plus d lambda. And in this spectrum, if d theta is proportional to d lambda, that is, angular dispersion is directly proportional to difference in the wavelength of the spectral lines, then such a spectrum is called a normal spectrum. And here, what the expression says, d theta, the angular dispersion d theta is more in a grating, more in case of a grating having more lines per meter. D theta also increases with increase in order. D theta varies inversely as theta, cosine theta. Or if theta is very small, cos theta approximated to 1. In that case, theta 0 means cos theta 0, cos theta 1 means the value of this one is maximum, so that what it says, angular dispersion is minimum. When theta is 0, angular dispersion is minimum. This is about dispersive power of a grating. Next is Rayleigh's criteria for resolution of spectral lines. Suppose in the spectrum of the light which is used to illuminate the grating, suppose there are two spectral lines, say lambda and lambda plus d lambda. Suppose those two spectral lines are very close to each other. One example I can give is the spectrum of sodium light. It consists of two spectral lines having wavelengths, wavelength difference of 6 nanometer. The difference in the wavelength is very, very small, so that the two spectral lines are very closely spaced. In such a case, using the grating, it is possible to resolve those two spectral lines. Resolving means giving the separate image of those two closely spaced lines. That is the resolution. The capacity of the instrument, and here it is a grating, capacity of the grating to resolve those two closely spaced lines is called the resolving power. And there is a criteria for resolution of the spectral lines. See, there are three cases. When there are two spectral lines very closely spaced, the lines may be well resolved, the lines may be unresolved or not resolved, or the lines may be just resolved. Just resolution means they are just separated, giving us the idea that there are two lines. The separation between them is very, very small. Still, we get the idea that there are two lines. Well resolved means the separation is very large, well separated. So clearly we can see that there are two lines. Unresolved means not at all resolved, means they overlap on each other. These are the three cases when there are two spectral lines very closely spaced to each other. Then, what Rayleigh's criteria says? Rayleigh's criteria for just resolution. Just resolution means the two lines appear just separated. Rayleigh's criteria is for that just resolution is the two spectral lines of wavelengths lambda and d lambda plus d lambda, they are just resolved if the principal maximum of lambda plus d lambda coincides with the first minimum of the spectral line lambda. First minimum means first secondary minimum of the spectral line lambda. The two spectral lines are said to be just resolved if principal maximum of one spectral line falls on the first secondary minimum of the other spectral line. Either lambda or principal maximum of lambda over first secondary minimum of lambda plus d lambda, or vice versa. In that case, the two spectral lines are said to be just resolved. See, using the diagram, we can explain it like this. See here, we have two principal maxima, say nth order. These two principal maxima are the principal maxima of lambda and lambda plus d lambda. When the two spectral lines are just resolved, see, principal maximum of one spectral line falls on the first minimum of the other. Look at this diagram. See here, this is the principal maximum of lambda. This is the principal maximum of lambda plus d lambda. And you can see here that the principal this maximum of lambda coinciding with the first minimum of lambda plus d lambda. Maximum of lambda coinciding with falling on the first secondary minimum of lambda plus d lambda. Or, see, maximum of lambda plus d lambda falling on the first secondary minimum of lambda. This is the case of just resolution. In this case, we say that the two spectral lines are just resolved. In the other way also, we can state it. See here, in case of just resolution, one more thing here is, the distance between the two principal maxima is equal to distance between the principal maxima and its own first minima. These two distances are equal. Distance between the two principal maxima equal to distance between the first principal maxima and its first minima. This is the case of just resolution. See, not resolved means the two principal maxima overlap. Well resolved means they are well separated. These are the Rayleigh's criteria for just resolution, unresolved and well resolved lines. Now, what is the resolving power? In general, any optical instrument, need not be grating, any other, say telescope or a microscope, their resolving power is nothing but their capacity to give, or the ability to give, the separate images of two nearby objects. Their capacity to give the separate images of to nearby objects. It is called as resolving power in general of any optical instrument. In case of a grating, now let us find out what is the expression for the resolving power. Consider a grating having n number of lines per meter on its surface, or n dash the number of lines on the n dash the number of lines on the grating surface, n number of lines per unit number of lines per meter on the grating surface. Consider a grating having n dash number of lines on its surface. And in a grating, the resolving power is defined as the ratio of wavelength of the one of the spectral lines to the difference in their wavelength. This ratio lambda to d lambda is called the resolving power of the grating. So here we have two spectral lines, lambda and lambda plus d lambda. Let theta n and theta n plus d theta be the angles of diffraction of those two lines to produce their own principal maximum of nth order. So that for the wavelength lambda, the condition is a plus b sine theta n equal to n lambda. And the direction of nth principal maximum of lambda plus d lambda is, what is it? A plus b sine theta n plus d theta equal to n into lambda plus d lambda. So these two equations gave the conditions to produce nth principal maximum of lambda and lambda plus d lambda. Now, when the two lines are just resolved, principal maximum of one falls on the first to secondary minimum of the other. Say, principal maximum of this, lambda plus d lambda, falls on the first minimum of lambda c. In that case, the direction of the first to secondary minimum of wavelength lambda is nothing but theta n plus d theta, same as this one, is it not? Direction of first to secondary minimum of lambda is equal to direction of nth principal maximum of lambda plus d lambda. They coincide, that's the meaning. So that theta n plus d theta is the direction of first to secondary minimum of this. And we already derived the expression for, or already discussed this one, the every secondary minima, first, second, third and so on, secondary minima are produced when the wavelength changes, sorry, not wavelength, path difference changes by a value lambda by n dash. So when the path difference changes by a value lambda by n dash, first secondary minimum is produced. So that the first secondary minimum of this lambda is given by the condition a plus b sine theta n plus d theta equal to n lambda plus lambda by n dash. This is the condition to produce the first secondary minimum of lambda. This is the increase in the path difference. Now, from equations 2 and 3, from these two equations, if we compare, left hand sides are equal, right hand side should be equal, equate them. Then this left hand side is n lambda plus n d lambda equal to n lambda plus lambda by n dash. N lambda gets cancelled. So what do you get? N d lambda is equal to lambda by n dash. Or if you simplify it, from this you get n d lambda is lambda by n dash, or what is resolving power? Lambda by d lambda is n dash. This is the expression for resolving power of the grating. So resolving power depends on the number of lines on the grating surface. What is n dash? Number of lines, total number of lines on the grating surface. So this resolving power depends on the number of lines on the grating surface. More is the number of lines, more will be the resolving power. More clearly, the separate images will be obtained in case of a grating. N is the order. This is about resolving power and dispersive power of the grating. Now let us compare the grating spectra and prism spectra. Prism spectra, the spectrum obtained using the prism. So using an instrument called spectrometer and using grating and prism, we can see the spectrum of white light as well as the monochromatic light like sodium. So what are the differences between grating spectra and prism spectra? In case of a grating, we get a number of spectra on either side of the central maximum. we already discussed grating is similar to the diffraction taking place in n number of slits. In a grating, the diffraction taking place in n number of slits, so that we get many orders of principal maxima. Those principal maxima are nothing but the different spectrum in case of white light. When we use white light, mercury light, mercury vapor lamp gives white light. White light combination of seven colors, Webb joint. So the spectrum of white light consists of seven colors, violet to red. So in case of a grating, we get a number of such spectra, different orders, first order, second order, third order, and so on. But in laboratory, maximum means up to the third order. More than that, beyond that, the spectra are not visible because their intensity goes on decreasing. The first order is more intense, second order intensity less, third order still less, higher orders, their intensity goes on decreasing. So maximum means three orders can be seen in the laboratory on either side of the central maximum. But in case of a prism, only one spectrum is produced, only one spectrum in white light. And in case of grating, by knowing the grating element, that is A plus B, and also by measuring angle of diffraction, wavelength of any spectral lines can be calculated. So to calculate the wavelength in case of a grating spectrum, we should know the grating element A plus B, or number of lines per meter on the grating surface, and we should measure the angle of diffraction so that lambda can be calculated. But in case of prism, we have to calculate the refractive indices of the material of the prism for different colors. That is done by measuring angles of deviation. Then we calculate the wavelength of the spectral lines. In case of grating spectra, the angle of diffraction or the angle of deviation is less for violet and or minimum for violet. Out of those seven colors, minimum for violet, maximum for red. But it is reverse in case of prism spectrum. The deviation is maximum for violet, minimum for red. And grating spectra, the intensity of the spectral lines less compared to the intensity of the prism spectral lines. Spectral lines of the prism spectra. Prism spectra, the spectral lines are very intense. Why the difference is, in case of grating, we have a central maximum. So almost all the intensity is at the central maximum, so that the intensity of the spectral lines of higher order that goes on decreasing. But in prism, only one spectrum, the lines are very intense. And dispersive power, prism grating is d theta by d lambda nn by cos theta. That of the prism is d mu by mu minus 1. Then one more difference is, the spectral lines in a grating spectrum are evenly distributed, so the spectrum is called rational spectrum. But in prism spectrum, the lines are not evenly distributed, so it is a irrational spectrum. One more is, resolving power of a grating, it is nn dash and it is very high, whereas resolving power of the prism is less compared to that of the grating. This is about the comparison of grating spectra and prism spectra. The last one is, this is about the resolving power of a telescope. Resolving power of a telescope, its ability to give the separate images of two closely spaced objects, and telescope is used to see the distant objects. And so the resolving power is 1 by d theta. D theta is called limit of resolution. That limit of resolution d theta, nothing but the angular separation between those two objects which are at a larger distance, at a greater distance. D theta is the angular separation, nothing but limit of resolution, given by 1.22 lambda by A, where lambda is the wavelength of the light reaching the object of the telescope. A is the aperture of the telescope or the diameter of the telescope. This is about resolving power of a telescope. With this, we finished this, the second unit, polarization and diffraction also.